Out of Mr. Telefero TV, how's everybody doing out there? Couple big time figures. These people have been successful since the 90s. They're both in the news for two totally different reasons, but at some point, bank accounts are going to be discussed in both situations. Robert Kelly, let's start out here in Chicago. Yeah, it's not looking good for R. Kelly. I believe he just did a show for about 13 grand, pretty much like a little walkthrough. He is struggling to get booked for shows right now because of the allegations and now the charges that have been presented against him in regards to having sex with underage women. Right now, R. Kelly is currently being tried for 10 counts of aggravated criminal sexual abuse, which could very well be from relationships he's had with women when they were under 18, doing disrespectful things to women. There's a lot going on with Robert Kelly, aka that nasty man in Chicago, and it's affecting his money. He's unable to do shows. A lot of shows R. Kelly has tried to get booked behind the scenes, him and his team, and just to be 100% honest with you, protesters are just not going for it. If they find out R. Kelly's getting booked in your city, they're threatening to protest outside of the building. They're threatening to never go to an event at this facility again. Any sponsor that gets behind an R. Kelly show, people are saying, nope, we boycotting it. Nope, we boycotting whatever brand it is. And people are just afraid to get behind the brand of Robert Kelly, the nasty man in Chicago right now. And because of that, it has been tough for R. Kelly to make money. He currently owes a lot in child support. He owes a lot for recording studios. As a matter of fact, if you watch the Surviving R. Kelly documentary, there's a very famous Chicago studio that was present in a documentary where a couple believes their child was being held captive in via R. Kelly. This studio is in shambles right now because R. Kelly has fell behind on rent. According to the Blast that's obtained some court documents, R. Kelly owes over $173,000 to the landlord, and the court has seized some of that money. Like, they're not even putting it in the hands of R. Kelly. They took the money from R. Kelly to keep him from behind bars for now. They took about $150,000 from him as a part of a court order, and reportedly R. Kelly's Wintrust bank account is at a negative $13 right now. Yeah, this is one of the biggest singers of all time. Listen, man, this just comes from, I'll be honest with you, this just comes from lack of education, lack of knowledge about the people in your team. And I would probably guess this comes from not treating people right around you and people taking advantage of you because they know you're not a good person, man. I'm going to be honest with you. This looks bad. This dude has had some of the biggest records ever. Records that your family, no matter what he's been accused of, they're going to play at their family reunions forever. They talking about the man that created I Believe I Can Fly. He made you step in the name of love. All these songs that will live the test of time, right? Dude has a negative $13 in one of his bank accounts. Now, it's worth noting that R. Kelly does have other bank accounts, but one account is in the negatives. Right? One of his major main bank accounts, because of his funding situation, is in the negatives. That's not good. Now, let's swing over to another infamous star. As a matter of fact, R. Kelly had agreed to do an interview with Wendy Williams, and she was on the fence of doing it or not. This was last year. She announced this on her show. Speaking of Wendy, she has her own situation going on. So it was announced the other day. I just wanted to be for sure about this one. I can confirm to you guys that Wendy Williams has officially filed for a divorce from her husband, Kevin Hunter. Now, as you all know, we've talked about Wendy and her husband, Kevin Hunter, on a couple times on our platform, just because she's used her platform to down a lot of our hip-hop artists over time, and her and 50 Cent going back and forth, and she's winning back and forth with T.I. and Future and other artists. We've talked about Wendy on our platform a few times. We've also talked about the fact that there's a reported side chick that her husband has had for at least a decade, and reportedly the dude then bought the side chick a home a street over from Wendy Williams and her husband's home. Not only that, this dude Kevin Hunter reportedly a week or two ago then had a baby with the side chick. So that dude, that nigga taking it to the next level. He giving the side chick all the main chick privileges. All right, so Wendy has filed for a divorce from her husband. Reportedly, there's been some physical abuse, some verbal abuse over the years with Wendy. And she's went on that television stream for years and talked about everybody's business but her own. And acted like everything was good in her home. But to me, saying that you're getting a divorce from your husband, as you went on camera countless times and said, ain't nothing wrong with me and my husband, we're fine, these are false rumors and all that. Getting a divorce from your husband, at the bare minimum, at least refutes and to me hurts a little bit of your journalistic integrity that you've built with your fans over the years. There's something going on, Wendy, whether you want to admit it on camera or not. It was reported via TMZ and other big time outlets that right now Wendy Williams is looking for a new home. Her and her husband, since 1997, had been staying in New Jersey together, but she's now looking for a new home. Remember, Wendy Williams was public about living in a sober house. That was like a little bit over a month ago. She told her fans on the Wendy show that she had been in a sober house dealing with drug issues that have come back. Wendy's always been vocal about her struggle with drugs throughout her career and throughout her life. It looks like some of those issues have sparked back. And again, this is a report. I can't confirm this. Many are saying that one reason why Wendy's in a sober house is because of the treatment that has went on with her husband and her Kevin Hunter. I keep you guys up to date on this story and more. Man, some celebrities, big time figures in our African American community going through it right now. R. Kelly's getting broken and broke by the day, and Wendy's still trying to act like ain't shit going on in her home, but she didn't file for a divorce. I wish them nothing but the best of luck in both situations. I'm out. I came from nothing, but I want everything God has for me. I interview celebrities. I talk sports. I still represent the culture.
I got the kids. They tuned in.
You are now tuned in.
Tuned in.
Yeah, we locked in right now, Mr.
Telefair. Mr. Telefair.
Mr. Telefair.
Mr. Telefair.
Shout out to Mr. Telefair.
You're watching Mr. Telefair TV.
Mr. Telefair TV. Here with the Triple B's. You can't do nothing but win.